Hey, welcome back. So tonight we're going to try and solve a problem that I've had before in the past. It's a pretty easy problem to solve for the front. You can actually just buy one of these monkey hubs. And the problem is putting monkey wheels on the rear of a Honda. Now, for the front, you can buy one of these hubs. You can buy them from your local Chinese distributor. They are usually about 60 bucks, and it is a monkey flange. So monkey bikes in Japan are basically a street legal version of like the Z50 and the mini trails we had here. They have a ton of wheels. I mean, like, there's like a crazy selection of wheels available for those. These are Kitico monkey bike wheels. Daytona makes monkey bike wheels. There's all kinds of weird little obscure ones and stuff. They're very neat and they're very plentiful and they're like reasonably cheap. So I've always wanted to put monkey bike wheels on just because I can pick them up for not very much money on Yahoo.jp, and they look cool. Although there's lots of different patterns for some, there's like pretty neat looking monkey bike wheels. Again, that's pretty easy to solve for the front. This fits basically right into the wheel itself and bolts in with four bolts. The problem comes in the rear. So I have seen over the years adapters made up that do allow fitting of a monkey bike wheel onto a rear. On the Spree, for example, I actually have a Kimco DD17 hub, which is like the standard hub that a lot of aftermarket wheels for Dios use, which has a much bigger center hole here, and the bolt pattern I think is 4x137. Those are pretty readily available. You can find them everywhere, but the wheel selection for those is, I mean, there are wheels for those as well, but they don't, for me personally, I like the look of the little hub and the little bolt pattern and the full face wheel. And again, because monkey bikes are everywhere in Japan, the wheels are fairly easy to get off Yahoo.jp. So, enter this. This is an AliExpress ZX wheel clone. Now, they come as a pair. There's a front and a rear, but we only really are interested in the rear. They're pretty light and flimsy. However, they're not light and flimsy in this. It's actually quite thick between here and the face. I mean, just guessing, that's probably, I'm gonna take a stab at it and say at least 3/8 of an inch thick, if not thicker. And it has a cast in steel liner and steel hub insert already made for a Dio. So I saw on Yahoo.jp one night when I was browsing on it, a gentleman was selling these essentially for 20,000 yen, which is approximately like 230 or 240 bucks Canadian. And by looking at it, I could kind of tell, being a machinist, that it was definitely kind of like a homebrew thing, like somebody had made it out of something else. So I started looking on AliExpress for cheap Dio wheels that didn't have, so the problem with the OEM wheels is it's not very thick here, whereas these ones are, this is pretty thick. So you could, even if you wanted to, fill this in with weld, but we're not actually going to need to do that, I don't think. So after seeing that on Yahoo.jp, I spent a little time digging around trying to find cheap Dio wheels that I could modify to make a hub adapter. So I found these. These were $50 plus $50 to ship. And like I said, they come with two, so you end up with an extra disc front wheel for whatever. It's kind of useless, but Gene was gracious enough to give me the front wheel and I put it on the drag scoot, so I'll probably be showing that when I do another drag scoot video here in the future. So basically, it's thick enough, I think, that you can definitely drill and tap it. For the bolts, for the Allen keys for this, and it's thick enough that I don't think that thinning this out a little bit for the register for here is going to really adversely affect the strength of it. So I think this is a prime candidate for making a hub adapter. So before we get too far into this, I'm going to just share the general measurements of the Monkey hub assembly, like what the PCD is, or the pitch circle diameter, what this inner bore diameter is. We'll do a little sketch up and just kind of show that aspect of it. Hey guys, you may be wondering why I am reintroducing myself mid-video. It's because I am Future Joel. This is actually the night after most of the recording and everything else, but the recording got messed up for this section, so I'm just redoing it really quick. This is the drawing for the hub. So if you're looking at it like this, this is the turned diameter here. So this register that actually sits, the rim sits on, is about 75 millimeters. I would make it slightly under 75 millimeters just because it has to fit on. If they're both the same size, they're not gonna fit to like 74.95 or 74.9 or something like that. The width that I ended up getting it at was 207 thou from this face to this face, so the distance from here to there. And the pitch circle diameter, which is the diameter that these all sit on, is about 91 millimeters. I measured this one across here and then subtracted the diameter of one of those bolts, and I got about 90.8-ish was the number that I got, so I just rounded it up to 91. That little bit shouldn't really make a difference. There's clearance in the holes there. But I have read online that these are actually 90, so I don't know which one is holds true. I'm measuring one here right now that fits the wheels, and I'm getting about 91. So I would probably go with whatever I'm getting measured, but here you can also, I think 90 would fit all the same. Again, there's clearance in the holes that are on the rim. And the only other thing that you may need to figure out is if you're laying it out, maybe the distance from center hole to center hole, which you may not have, but you can trig it out. Because this is broken into four quadrants, that's 90 degrees, which means that that's going to be 45 degrees there. And just half of this, so it would be 45.5 millimeters for the length of the hypotenuse. So you have an angle of 45 and 45.5 millimeters for the hypotenuse. You can use trig and figure out this side and then add it twice to get your length between the holes. That's it. Okay, bye. Oh, and even though I hit 207 here, I would still try and only take it down as far as just to clean up these faces. So inside of here, you can see I actually went a little bit further than I'd like, just to leave as much material on the face as possible. So where these like little scalloped reliefs are, just basically turn it until that cleans up, and then when you put the wheel on, it'll register on a flat surface the whole way around. But that just leaves the most material for the through bolting. I got a little bit over a quarter of an inch of pull through, so it's 270 thou. If you left those on there, you'd be closer to 300 thou, which would be ideal. If you are making one of similar type or whatever, like I said, just make sure if you're turning the diameter, you just want to go until you start to clean up that little, the bottom edge of this weird little scallop in the face, just enough so that it cleans up, and then you're leaving the most material on the face as possible for your threaded holes. Thank you.
So that's the hub adapter. Fits in. Allows for a monkey bike diameter. I still have to drill and tap for the through bolts, but it has a shoulder to register on, so all the load's not just on the bolts. And basically when you lay this out, you're gonna have two bolt holes coming out this way. Two of them are gonna be really close to the edge of this, and maybe even like lightly on the edge, depending on how irregular the casting is. That won't really matter too much. If you put a light chamfer on that, that first thread's gonna go away anyway. So it'll be fine, I would think. But there you go. I'm kind of running out of battery for the camera, so I might skip out on showing you how to drill it. That's it for me for this evening. Until next time, take care.